After a semi-impromptu decision, our voyage across the Pacific begins today, February 12th. Underway!
There's a place to where the boat is from. It takes away all of your big problems. You can worries, you can drop them in a blue ocean. But you gotta get away to where the boat is from. Take one part sand, one part sea, one part shade of a big palm tree, and the drinks that cool in the reggae.
And 100 miles outside of Panama, at last Neptune delivers a tuna.
Know your big problems, you can worries, you can drop them in a blue ocean, but you gotta get away to where the boat.
Happy Valentine's Day, girls.
Happy Valentine's
Day. Lather up. Make
yourself a pat of cake.
Very
good.
Can
you make some heart-shaped ones?
We're lucky that they're even oval.
Today, we did 132. Nautical miles, not too shabby, and it looks like our average from noon to noon for day two will be even higher than that.
Have your coat, you won't need it where we are going. Get away to where the boat leaves from. It takes away all of your big problems. You can worries, you can drop them in a blue ocean, but you gotta get away to where the boat leaves from. Pick me up, pick me up, pick me up.
It is glassy, smooth out there. Not hardly a lick of wind. Can't see anything at all. But there's Jessie. Their morning coffee and morning check-in on the radio net, but it is calm. So, charge up our batteries and make some water and have a good time today. But I think today we actually get to become what, Jessie? What do we become today? Yep, our Pollywog status will be over. We had 5 days almost of really amazing sailing, and then last night it's like someone turned the fire hose off, and we just brought in sail, as you can see, brought in our jib and put a little flake of main out for some stability, and we just drifted all night like it was nothing. What are we doing, guys?
We're cracking ourselves up.
It's arts and crafts time on the high seas.
Making headdresses and other important accessories for our equator crossing.
Right. And why is that?
Because we are going to be transitioning from slimy, lowly pollywogs to trusty shellbacks. And we need to do it in style.
That's right. Let's look at our accoutrements. What do we have here?
We've got loads of beads, an assortment of small plastic ocean-going animals, string, shells, twine, random nonsense, more shells and strings and random nonsense. We'll have to wait and see what becomes of this.
We recycle.
Yes.
It's the dinghy painter.
That's right. Reduce, reuse, recycle, everyone. Show you our position. We are right here. Our vessel position, 00 degrees north, 41 minutes. 88 degrees west, 29 minutes. Right there is the equator.
Oh, we made it! Shellbacks!
Yeah! You're on!
Woo!
Yeah, look at that. Golly.
Measuring in degrees south from here on down.
Hear ye, hear ye, all Pollywogs, assemble on the deck.
That means me too.
All right. King Neptune presiding over the dastardly Pollywog trials of the sailing vessel Red Thread.
We will begin first by reviewing the dastardly deeds of we Pollywog.
Dastardly! All right. Who goes first? This is Jessie from Lori.
All right!
Oh, okay.
Jess's homegrown Spanish is grand, though sometimes a meaning backwards she lands. No comprende is one phrase that often she says that translate, you don't understand.
Oh, the shame.
Shame!
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 Shame.
Dastardly deed!
Finger wagging or whatever.
Shame!
Shame! Oh, I'm losing gels.
That's alright. Alright, next.
Next.
It is to Jessie from Neil. Pollywog shame! Dastardly deed of neglect and wishful thinking. Jessie, skipper of the fair and true vessel the Red Thread, hath forsook the trust and confidence placed upon her by her hard-working and just crew, me and Lori. Shame to the willful neglect of our provisions. Shame to her for neglecting the egg stores. Her lack of attention and honest good care hath resulted in the waste of eggs, their delicious and filling yolks settling, hardening, and becoming rancid. Ew. Dastardly deed! Three times the shame to Jessie! Shame! 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 Shame.
It worked. I feel very ashamed. Rotten eggs. Awesome.
All right. To Neil from Lori.
Okay. To Neil. A pot of coffee Neil did brew in the interest of keeping awake his crew. Ooh. Some still in the pot, then a big puff we got. Contents scattered as far as the loo!
I like it.
Shame! Shame!
Shame!
Right. Jessie, your turn.
To Lori from Jess.
Oh no.
Lori the Lovely, our first long-term crew, was given a task list of prep work to do. Water filters, jacklines, other parts filled her bags, but when she arrived at the Red Thread, she had failed just one task. With so many days ahead to spend on the sea, it's the little things in life that make luxury. In all the commotion, she forgot a favorite of mine. Truffle oil, my beloved divine!
Shame!
Shame! Shame!
All right, Lori, you picked one of the last ones here.
All right. This one is to Lori from Neil.
All right.
Roasting me.
Shame! Dastardly shame to Lori, crew of the faithful vessel Red Thread. For she hath forsaken the ancient trust of the seagoing ship and incurred hateful damage to her equipment. Through neglect and clumsiness hath Lori, hot-footed in the tropical sun, tore from stern stanchion the lifeblood and vigor of yon serious satellite radio antenna. Dastardly deed for shame. Three times a shame to Lori. Shame! Shame! Shame!
And last but not least, to Neil from Jessie. The captain of the ship, a good captain is he, but at times a bit dastardly, oh yes he can be. At Ensenada del Veradero, our last port of call, we dinghied to the playa to play we three all. We packed salty snacks ashore, met a mate, and that naive captain of ours gave our nibbles away. A hungry crew gets hangry, so Lori jumped to her feet, Pile on those totals! We want something to eat! All's well that ends well, we shared our snack on the sand, and the captain managed to avoid the back of my hand. Shame on Neil. Shame, shame, shame.
Oh, very well done indeed.
Awesome.
Okay. With all the shaming.
That deserves a quick one. I lost my
one more.
That
was good. And with that,
oh, the shame, that's it.
Now we turn to reading. Oh. Travelers of the Tropics. To all sailors, wherever ye may be, and to all the pollywogs, mermaids, sea serpents, whales, porpoises, sharks, dolphins, eels, skates, and other living denizens of the sea, greetings. Know ye that on September 17th, 2016, in latitude 0 and in longitude 088 degrees, 53 minutes, there appeared within our royal domain the sailing vessel, the Red Thread, bound for the Galápagos Islands. Having been found now worthy to be numbered among the honored and trusty shellbacks, have been duly initiated. Solemn mysteries of the ancient order of shellbacks. We have a fancy certificate to keep, painted by the brilliant artist, Puzia Morin.
Oh, that's amazing.
Show it to the camera.
Yeah. We begin the celebration.
Indeed.
Bubbly. El Capitan.
Bubbly. Let's do this. Here we go.
Sorry.
Couldn't ask for a better crew.
Awesome.
We've officially all turned into shellbacks. Congratulations, you guys.
We made it. Looks like we made it.
In about, I don't know, 18 hours, probably we'll be anchored off in the Galápagos. Cheers to that.
Cheers.
Oh, help, Dad.
Who's in the hat?
Dad wouldn't mind from up above a little champagne on his hat.
Maybe that was him shaking things right.
That's right.
So this is the part of the equator crossing where now we do science.
This might look like a bottle of Captain Morgan. Perhaps you think it maybe is a bottle of Captain Morgan rum blanco. You would be incorrect. This bottle is actually a bottle of salt water that Jesse and I are doing to help with a program to take a look at all of the microplastics in the world's oceans. So we thought it was good today, our equator crossing, to go ahead and do our first sample.
Here we have an empty bottle of Okanagan wine, and we have written a message and put our boat card in to commemorate our equator crossing and send well wishes that whomever finds it gets the opportunity to live their dreams just as we are.
So I think it's about 8,000 feet deep here.
Shellbacks are really good swimmers.
In you go, Neil. In you go.
Give yourself a lot of that line.
Yeah, I've got a big old chunk of it here.
Rip your arm off.
Yeah. Oh, man.
How was that?
Cold, actually.
Oh, really?
Colder than I expected, but it's still warm. It's just...
Woo! Your reaction didn't say it's warm.
Oh, this is awesome.
You're being like, pull the log.
This is cool. I like this shit.
Could you?
What about the orcas? What about the orcas we saw, Lori?
And
oh,
here.
It's cold. It's really good, actually. Though. It feels so good.
So, farm girl from Utah jumping in at the equator.
Whoa!
Where it's like 9,000 feet deep.
Whoa, look at the boat healing all over. Okay, I did it.
Alright, land ho. Here is Isla San Cristóbal in the Galápagos. We are rolling into day 7. It's early in the morning, about 6 o'clock in the morning local time. And we can now see the Galápagos.
Turns out it's February. Shit, seriously?
Yeah.
Well, shame, shame, shame!